I decided to get ambitious and go to the grocery store on foot. And then of course I bought way too many heavy items. My arms are tired. It was like a mile at least. So I'm low-key just smoking a joint in a graveyard like a fucking teenager. It's such a vibe. And the clouds. Those are clouds. Aren't they fluffy and gorgeous? And then the water behind is all misty. It's a vibe. I've been in isolation for almost a month now, aside from like brief interactions with the grocery clerk and a couple Airbnb hosts. And I'm feeling a little crazy. I'm just roller skating around my Airbnb because I'm going crazy with my own thoughts. This spot has really saved me. I keep coming back here every day just to listen to the noises I hear and put my feet in the water, touch a tree. Some things didn't work out that I thought would, and I have no closure with them. It's kind of a mystery, which has kind of been a theme throughout my life. And I'm just kind of letting go and releasing the not knowing and staying here in the present instead of worrying about the future, dwelling on the past. I'm just trying to be right here, right now, and feel joy in this moment and not worry about what happens when I check out of this Airbnb 3 days from now when the person who said they were going to be my roommate ghosted me. I think I'm just quantum leaping so quick. My vibration is changing so quick. I'm leveling up so quick. I'm no longer a vibrational match for the entire life that I just manifested, which at the time was like a dream for me. And now I'm just tapping right back into now and what is it I really want? I manifested that whole situation. I'm like, I can do anything I want to do. So now I'm just trying to figure out what that is and bring it into reality. Materialize it, realize it, make it real. Today was a day unplanned. I thought I was going to have a place to live tomorrow, June 1st, but now I do not. So I organized my car and I'm going to take it one day at a time and follow my joy. And when I was really alone and quiet with myself for an extended period of time, I realized that part of me is a little bit afraid to settle down and stop moving. Maybe I'm not quite ready to. Maybe there's a reason, even though I've been trying so hard to force settling down, maybe there's a reason I'm supposed to keep going a little longer. I have had an intuitive knowing since about February that by October I will definitely be settled where I'm supposed to be. Who says Mondays have to suck? Ooh, what's down here? You want to go down the stairs, Seren? I'm out here exploring. Whoa, what was that? What was that? It looked like a groundhog or something. Anyway, we're out here in Augusta, Maine. And I feel like it's the first day of the rest of my life.
I feel like fairies definitely come here. Don't you, Seren?
Aww. This tree is actually sheltering us from the sprinkling a little bit. Huh, Sereni? Whenever I'm out places like this, I'm always like, I wonder if there's any like hidden bodies buried here. This is my psychedelic rain setup so I can keep adventuring in the rain. I have my confetti umbrella and then I bought this like holographic, just like waterproof. I mean, not waterproof, but you know, it'd take a while for that to soak through. So we can keep adventuring even when the rain starts because I don't want to sit in my car all day. This is definitely of power. Right, Seren? She's like, I don't know, tell me when you're done. Okay, okay, this person's definitely meditating out here. Are you hot? Are you my soulmate? Do I want to know you? I want to meet my man just meditating by the water. I just wanted to shout out Nikki, Northern Dog Wrecker Heisman, because I learned this watching her vlog. She lives in a car with her dog and she just hangs up all her wet stuff so it doesn't get musty and stinky in the back. So I'm taking her advice. Sometimes when you just don't know what else to do, just take your cat for a walk on the beach and it'll all be okay. Couldn't film it because I was just trying to follow her and not fall off a rock, but Serenity just climbed up all of these rocks. You are an explorer. Do you want to come out?
You're silly.
When I was alone in the woods for 6 nights with my cat, yes, I know, I thought to myself, what do I really want? If I was being completely honest with myself, because part of me is still clinging to being realistic with my dreams and my manifestations, but the truth is I can do whatever I want. But I don't know, it's kind of like with manifestation, you kind of just have to prove it to yourself over time that you are worth more and deserve more, and like you kind of have to prove to yourself that miracles can seriously just happen and things fall from the sky. I shit you not, I can spend hours, days, weeks looking online for housing or what the job, whatever it is I'm looking for. I can work my ass off for something and I will never ever get it. The harder I work, the less I get, and then all of a sudden the most random perfect situation will literally come out of nowhere, like in a way I couldn't have predicted, couldn't have imagined, I couldn't even dreamed up myself. So that's why when you're manifesting, you kind of can't, my best tip is like, you can't worry about the how you're gonna get what you want. You kind of just have to release it and like put it on the universe's to-do list and trust that the universe will bring it into your life, or God or whatever, in the way that the perfect way for you, because it's usually so kismet and out there, like you couldn't have even like imagined it ever happening. So I'm in a funny situation now where I have a job and I have a home. They're both coming. I know they're both mine and they're both coming, but I don't have a start date for either one of them at this point in time. And so I have an undisclosed amount of time before either of these things I know are here for me start. And I was like, well, I don't want to just loiter around Maine. I have this freedom. And Maine isn't actually my favorite place, you guys. Like, I'm here for an opportunity that I was called to receive. But Maine isn't my end game. Maine is a stepping stone. There's other places I loved way more. And I asked myself if I could do anything I wanted right now, not thinking about money, not thinking about what I'm supposed to be doing, not thinking about what anyone else thinks I should be doing, what would I want to spend this time doing? Being completely honest with myself. And the answer was, I'd want to go back and visit all the friends I met along the way. Well, all my favorites. So that's what I'm gonna do. Serenity and I are gonna rest up in a hotel for 2 nights. We did car life last 2 nights. We've kind of been back and forth with having rented places to stay and going in the car. I just figure now that I'm at the end of the journey, I'm down to spend more money on places to stay. At the beginning, I would only not do the car if I had like a friend to sleep with for free. I was just like being real thrifty, not trying to spend money on housing, because that's really what you'll spend the most money on. Like really, for this lifestyle, just in the car, all you need is gas and food and car maintenance.
Meow.
And okay, eavesdrop in, dude. There's a whole fucking this lady though in the red. Oh my god, she just walked hella close to me. People are like hella eavesdropping, trying to see what I'm like sitting here talking to myself on the beach about. I don't blame them. I'd be curious too. I am literally a lady just vibing on the beach with my cat. What I've been doing now is just asking myself in each present moment, I'm just trying to be very present moment, like, what do I want to do right now? What will bring me joy? Not worrying about anything else, nothing monetary, what anyone's thinking. And that's how I ended up at the beach. I'm like, it's getting too warm out now. You know, I started the trip in winter, but now it's getting heated up. You can't just sit in your car all day, even if you're tired and want to rest. And I was like, well, where do people go to lounge when it's hot? And I was like, oh yeah, the beach. There's this Lana Del Rey song. All I wanna do is get high by the beach, get high, baby, baby, bye-bye. You know that I never bought into your bullshit. I don't even know all the words yet. Like, I do just want to get high by the beach. So now that the summer is basically here and it's hot every day, it's like 90 degrees today, there's nowhere to go living in a car with a cat every day but the beach. Then when I got to the beach, it said no dogs, but didn't say no cats.
Another kitty beach day. There's nothing else to do when you live in a car with a cat and it's hot out, I swear.
Hey girls, it's ladies' night. Oh, what a night. I am the black sheep in the family too. Bye, bitches. Sammy, I see him. Sammy!
See him?
He's so cute frolicking.
Come on. Sam, come on. Yeah, good boy. Good job.
You ever seen a cat at the oil change? I'm passing Scranton, like the office. Ba-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-
you hear screaming.
Mommy, I'm home! And I'm vlogging!
Sparkles on too.
You know what's so funny? I spilt it on this side and I thought I'll be Chiara today.
I run on Letty's love.
I'm pretty low these days. I don't know.
I just pulled up to my next sketchy motel and there's just a cat chilling on the bush outside my room.
Trusting my cat to guard the sketchy motel.
Okay, I followed coordinates to get to Aiden's Valspire water tower. Serenity is on my back. Anyone ever peed with a cat on their back? Because I have now. It is 90 degrees. I'm perspiring even in the shade. I'm sweating and there might be a spider on me. Okay, I need a stick for spiders. Aiden needs to give directions for where he... Okay, could I jump that? Let's see, I don't even know if... I can't fit through here with the cat backpack. Scary. I had a fall off camera. I fell into the ditch. Serenity, I know. She's like, bitch, I'm in a backpack, so if anything happens to you... Ah, fuck. Okay, I'm gonna need another shower today. Ow. Oh my god, I can see one of the Adam tags where Aiden came back and wrote, Adam sucks. That was silly. Only I would get a tattoo yesterday and then face plant into some dirt. And these aren't like real roads, so the map is like, I don't know what you're doing, guys. Adam. Adam really is everywhere, like actually. Oh my god, I can't believe I walked right under this thing multiple times and I didn't even notice I was walking right underneath it. Okay, but how does he get up here? Does he climb one of these? Hold the phone. Am I tripping? Oh. Up here, it looks like there's a ladder that starts here. But I don't think it's at the bottom here. So does he have to climb this thing up the ladder? Oh my god, yeah. He has to climb this. Holy shit. Do I do it? Do I climb this? Do I climb this? I was almost to the top with Serenity on my back. I got to the spot where like the ladder switches shapes a little bit when you're almost to the top. I don't know if it's because it's 95 degrees or I'm afraid of heights, but like I felt like I was gonna pass out, and I have passed out in the past. And I have Serenity on my back, and it's the kind of fall where if you fall, like, you're dead. And my cat would be dead too. Everyone would be dead. So I climb back down. If it wasn't 100 degrees, maybe I could. I have passed out before, and I'm alone. And I don't want to try it without Serenity because I don't want to leave her down here. I don't know what animals are out here. And then I'd feel awful if I left her and something happened. I'm bummed because I got so close. And I just want to make it to the top. I'm like, I came all the way here. I want to make it to the top. I think if I was with someone, I might. I kept asking people all the way here, like, how do you get to the water tower? And no one knew what I was talking about because there's a waterfall nearby everyone goes to. They're like, there's no water tower. It's just the waterfall. I'm like, y'all don't know about the Valspire water tower? Maybe I could come back later tonight when it cools off. I'm going to try that. Okay, my new plan is I have 50 minutes to dry my sweat and go meet this girl who I met on Valentine's Day on my road trip in Athens, Georgia. I like snuck Serenity into a bar by myself and got myself lettuce wraps and a drink, and these really cute little college girls like let me come into their birthday Valentine's Day group, and one of the girls from that day is in town and we're gonna have dinner together. All right, I'm getting Addie to drive me to the water tower because like my heart is pounding just at the thought of it. I'm so scared of heights, but like I want to do it so bad. I'm like, why? What is the psychology behind this standstill between me and a ladder? A really long one. I could fall to my death, but like I probably won't.
More than likely you'll be totally fine.
Okay, I'm gonna go stare at this ladder and maybe climb it. I just feel like I'm at the end of my road trip and I want to like face a fear or something. I don't know. I don't know what I'm trying to prove to myself. I'm like, am I trying to like impress myself or what? Addie has the exact same crack in her windshield as I do. Like exactly from the same place and same length. And mine just happened from a trek too. And like, I don't know. I accept it, but I'm like, that sucked. It says Valspire on it.
That old one?
Yes, this is it. Okay, and this time I will go the efficient way. I went the most roundabout way the first time I came here, but I'm glad I did because then I got to explore all the graffiti.
Okay, cool.
And so I'm glad I saw that while it was light out, but it was just like the sun was beating down, cat on my back. I thought I was gonna like pass out, and I'm like, maybe if I come back catless, when the sun's going down, I'll have a chance. I wanted to come back with someone, so if I like fall to my death, someone knows about it. My plan is, this is the challenge. I have to climb up, and I can't look down, because if I look down, I know I'll come back. But if I can just keep climbing up, I'll be okay. My heart's pounding.
Be safe.
Thank you.
Good luck, you got this. Thank you. my God, she's gonna do it. Wow! My girl made it! But Chiara is up there. There's the ground. She did it, lads.
That was worth it.
Here she comes.
How's it going?
Good, hey.
What are y'all doing?
Just some exploring.
Well, you know this is private property, right?
Yes, sir. We'll be out in a minute.
So why are you here?
My friend is kind of not from around here, and she was intrigued by this water tower.
Yeah, that's very dangerous.
Yes, sir.
Like, that thing is not secure.
Yes, sir.
How'd you get up there?
She had the ladder. I'm sorry. I'm on a road trip, and, one of my things on my bucket list was I've always wanted to climb a water tower.
Looking for